a social media manager for collective action for safe spaces. What brought me to my work with CAS and also here to testify today are feelings of frustration and fear. I've lived in several places in my life, but have never felt as at home as I do in DC. However, fighting back against my love for this city with equal and sometimes sadly stronger force is the fact that I've also never felt as unsafe as I do here. No matter where I am, no matter what time of day it is, getting from point A to point B leaves me feeling anxious. Whether I'm walking, taking the metro, or catching a bus, it would be a very rare day if at least three people did not make some sort of inappropriate or obscene comment about my body that left me feeling vulnerable. Whether I'm on a sidewalk or even inside a bar, I've been catcalled, I've been touched, I've been lunged at, and I've been followed. What's worse is the feeling of disempowerment for not knowing what to do. Does speaking out or holding back keep me safer? I've heard stories that go both ways. As social media manager for CAS, I receive dozens of tweets and comments a week from people experiencing the same treatment. They're always scared, they're always angry, and they never know what to do or who to turn to. Street harassment affects everyone. Most women, LGBTQ, and gender non-conforming people, and particularly people of color, who are at the highest risk, viewed as part of walking outside, commuting on public transit, and generally occupying public spaces. This problem is constantly reinforced because we've chosen to accept it as normal. So this is what we consider to be normal. 1 in 5 women will be sexually assaulted in her lifetime. 50% of sexual assaults use alcohol as an excuse. I and most of my friends change our daily paths and routes to work or social activities simply because we get harassed or feel unsafe. So I think it's time to change what we consider normal. I'm here to ask you to lead in collecting better data in a formalized way on public sexual harassment and assault, and in training relevant groups to stop sexually aggressive behavior and prevent sexual assault through a non-criminal, community-based, and survivor-informed approach like bystander intervention. CAS also wants to expand its trainings to those who are in a position to intervene in public spaces with high rates of public sexual assault and assault such as bars and the nightclubs, as well as high traffic sidewalks under public spaces. We have the tools to make public spaces safer for everyone, but we need the commitment from you, our key leaders in the city. Maybe then we can start calling safety the new normal. Thank you.